Today we are looking at Microsoft Azure's Playfab. Last time we looked at authentication, and now we're going to be doing saving and loading so that you can log into your account. You can play the game with the same account, same settings on any computer, on any device, and we can use that information to keep it the same across all of them. So the way we're going to go about this is I'm going to show you where we are right now with it, and then we're going to recap quickly what we did last time. I'm going to show you how to do the saving and loading. Then we're going to talk about what things we could do with the saving and loading, some next steps, what we could do to start polishing the game more. And eventually we will have a fully working game that people can log into and check it out. First, let's look at how it works. This is, by the way, this is Pocket People. It's like a little environment where we have either one or more little characters who can walk around and do things, interact with objects you place on the scene, or go and explore and pick up treasure and experience along the way while fighting off monsters. Here's where we are with it so far. It's very early stages, but you'll see some of the Playfab stuff in action so far. For example, we have our sign up page here. If you have an account, our login page requires email or password to log in. And if we sign up with a username, an email, and a password, we can click the sign up button. And here in our first playthrough, we're presented with a kind of mysterious looking screen. But once we press the dice, a character shows up. If we press it again, we see that it's randomizing the color. We're also with this game going to try, if we can, to have as little text as possible so that anyone with any language can play it. And hopefully we can convey the ideas with just some iconography and visual indicators. We'll see. It's an extra little challenge, but we're going to see how it goes. So right now we can randomize the colors. Let's say we decide to stick with the blue color. Then we continue on. What's going to happen behind the scenes is we will be saving this information to Playfab, and it will now set our character to be a blue little character. So there it is. So not much is happening, but our character can walk around the screen. We can tell it where to go, and eventually we'll put in some, it's got some nav mesh on it so that it can walk around the walls. Eventually we'll put in little items that it can pick up, that it can interact with, that maybe it'll play the drums, maybe it'll pick up a sword, and then we'll have some sort of button or area where it can go on adventure, and that will be automated, and then we can recall it. So we've logged in, we've picked our color, and we see the color here in the game. Now, if we log in again, or if we start the game again, we go to our login area with the same credentials we just put in. I think it was like this. We put in our password. And here we are, no more pop-up. It sees that it's a blue character, and now we can just get right back into the game. Pretty straightforward. Simple to see it, and actually, with Playfab, simple to implement. So let's look at it. Well, we're gonna look at it behind the scenes in a second, or like the code, the breakdown, how it works. But first I wanna catch you up on what we have so far. Well, in order to have play and loading happening, we need to have it authenticating first. Otherwise, you know, it doesn't know what account to be saving and loading from. The first thing you do to get Playfab working in Unity, we've already covered this last time, you have to install Unity. Also bring Playfab into Unity, which we did last time. And we have a tab for it. We've logged in with our Playfab account. You'll need a Playfab account. Here, let's bring up the code so we can see just a quick overview of what we did with it. So here we have, let's make it over here and let's put a darker background. While I love the transparency, let's make sure we can still see it. So we are using Playfab and playfab.clientModels in our namespaces here. And then what we do is we have the Unity UI set up, and then we use sign up. Here it is. So in sign up, we use register Playfab user request. We put in the email, we put in the password, and we put in the encrypted, we put in the username. On register request, if it's success, we do these things. And if it's an error, then we show the error. Then for login, we use login with email address request. We put in the email and password that's encrypted. And then we just log in with the email address. On the request here, if it's successful, we do login success. It looks like we log in. We do the same thing twice. We have a bug. Good thing we caught it. It should just be success and then error. So let's say error, login error, and this should be taking us to that. Okay, well, there we go, fixed a bug. And then we have a bunch of other stuff here that's allowing us to switch between the signup tab and the login tab. So that's pretty much what we have for our authentication. It's with Playfab, not too hard to do. And when you log into your Playfab account, here, I'll take it back a step so you can see what it looks like to get to Playfab. So I have a bunch of different games here and studio names. I should clean it up because I've been doing a lot of tests. But we have here Pocket People. We click on it. We see an overview of people who've been using it. This was our last stream when we were using it. I put it out for a day. And some testing I've been doing, registering users to test, save, and load. And then if we click on players, if you're using this and you're like, where's my players? Just click clear or search, and it will show you the people who've logged in, what countries, their ID. I guess it shows what they've been spending and their last login. So it shows all this information about them. And then when you click on the last user, it shows also some of these things here. And so what we're going to be looking at today is player data. And we're going to be using this information here to save and load information. Okay, so we will be doing this after login. You do need to be logged in, obviously, to get the information from that user. So we're going to do it once we're in the main scene, after we've already signed up, which on sign up we automatically logged in, or when we log in on a returning sign up. So we have, you know, a scene here, and what I have is this page with a dice to pick your character that will show up if you are coming in for the first time. If you don't have that information in the user's save, then that screen will come up and then it will save it. Next time you will not see it. But we are also using Playfab Load here. So here it is where we set the colors. Here's the colors that we apply, the materials that we apply to the mesh, and some of the screens that we turn off and on during that little process. So let's open Playfab Load. And we begin by looking at, here is get player data. So what I'm doing is, as soon as we start the scene, we get the player data. And that way, we can run Playfab client API dot get user data, new get user data request. And the keys that we're looking for is null, user data success, and on error. So on user data success, if we get information, then we can check if we have the key that we need and decide what to do with that. So for example, if we log in and we have no save info, either we don't have results.data at all, or we don't have the key that we're looking for, which is body color. If the data is null, or if we don't have that key, then we'll bring up the page, which will allow us to choose one and then set it for next time. If we do have that information, then we can take from results.data at this key, so it works like an array, dot value, and then that's an integer, and we can use that integer to tell which color we should be applying, and then we have a function to do that. Now, it gives us a string from the key, okay, so the dictionary is a string and a string, but what we can do is put a number in, and the value of that string we can turn into an int using int.parse so that we can feed that into our function, which applies the color. That is pretty much it for loading. Let's look at saving, and then I'll show you what it saves exactly. So in a kind of similar way, let's open up saving, actually. It's a separate file here. So we use, once we click the button and we select the character's color, then we save that information right away. So next time when they come in, we've already got it. And what we do is we call set body color data. So we are setting the string number, which is, so if we picked color 1, 2, 3, whatever material we pick, we're converting it to a string so that we can save it as a string. And we do set body color with the string, color number string. And we use Playfab client API dot update user data request. And then we set data to new dictionary string, which is body, and then body color data. So now we're using this keyword, which we had in our load, and we're setting this here. Set data success, we can just say that it's saved properly, and on error, we can display an error. And the way that looks in Playfab, over here, when we click on player data title, we can see here our dictionaries. So we have our player data here. This is our different keys. We have body color, and our value is at 0 for this player right now. So that correlates to blue in the game right now. And we can add as many of these as we like. So we can make full customization of the character and we can save all different values of the game for that player in here with the player data. So that's pretty much all you need to do. I'm going to show you guys again now that you kind of have an idea of what's going on while we do it. So once again, we log in. We'll type in our username, lanalux.games. Create a password. Sign up. And as you can see, it saw that I don't have information for that user yet. So we can pick the color. Let's pick yellow. Now I have a yellow character. It applied those settings as soon as we clicked the arrow button. And when we log in again with that user information, log in, and there's our character again. So there it is in action. I hope that that is something useful for you guys. I know I don't think this game would be nearly as cool if you could only play it with one save on one device. I think a game like this, especially an idle game, and one that's got like a really simple premise, is great for multi-platform and playing it across different devices. So I'm really excited to use Playfab for this. And I'm sure you could use this for so many different ideas, so many different ways. And that's it. Thanks guys for joining in and learning about Playfab today. I hope it was interesting for you. I know I'm really enjoying working with it. And we'll see you next time.